old man turned off the radio, said, where did all of the old songs go? Kids sure play funny music these days, and they play it in the strangest ways. Said, it looks to me like they've all gone wild. It was peaceful back when I was a child. Well, man, could it be that the girls and boys are trying to be heard above your noise? And the lonely voice of youth cries, what is truth? A little boy of three sitting on the floor looks up and says, Daddy, what is war? Son, that's when people fight and die. A little boy of three says, Daddy, why? Young man of 17 in Sunday school, being taught the golden rule. And by the time another year's gone around, it may be his turn to lay his life down. Can you blame the voice of youth for asking, what is truth? Young man sitting on the witness stand, the man with the book says, raise your hand. Repeat after me, I solemnly swear. The man looked down at his long hair, and although the young man solemnly swore, nobody seemed to hear anymore. And it didn't really matter if the truth was there. It was the cut of his clothes and the length of his hair. And the lonely voice of youth cries, what is truth? Young girl dancing to the latest beat has found new ways to move her feet. A young man speaking in the city square is trying to tell somebody that he cares. Yeah, the ones that you're calling wild are gonna be the leaders in a little while. This old world's waking to a newborn day, and I solemnly swear that it'll be their way. You better help that voice of youth find what is truth. And the lonely voice of youth cries, what is truth?
There once was a musical troupe, a pickin' singin' folk group. They sang the mountain ballads and the folk songs of our land. They were long on musical ability, folks thought they would go far, but political incompatibility led to their downfall. Well, the one on the right was on the left, and the one in the middle was on the right, and the one on the left was in the middle, and the guy in the rear was a Methodist. This musical aggregation toured the entire nation, singing traditional ballads and the folk songs of our land. They performed with great virtuosity, and soon they were the rage, but political animosity prevailed upon the stage. Well, the one on the right was on the left, and the one in the middle was on the right, and the one on the left was in the middle, and the guy in the rear burned his driver's license. Well, the curtain had ascended, a hush fell on the crowd, as thousands there were gathered to hear the folk songs of our land. But they took their politics seriously, and that night at the concert hall, as the audience watched deliriously, they had a free-for-all. Well, the one on the right was on the bottom, and the one in the middle was on the top, and the one on the left had a broken arm, and the guy on his rear said, oh dear. Now this should be a lesson. If you plan to start a folk group, don't go mixing politics with the folk songs of our land. Just work on harmony and diction, play your banjo well, and if you have political conviction, keep them to yourself. Now the one on the left works in a bank, and the one in the middle drives a truck.
The one on the right's an almighty J, and the guy in the rear got drafted. Should remember well, from the land of the Pima Indian, a proud and noble band who farmed the Phoenix Valley in Arizona land. Down the ditches a thousand years, the waters grew Ira's people's crops, till the white man stole their water rights and the sparkling water stopped. Now Ira's folks were hungry, and their land grew crops of weeds. When war came, Ira volunteered and forgot the white man's creed. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. There they battled up Iwo Jima Hill, 250 men, but only 27 lived to walk back down again. And when the fight was over, and Old Glory raised, among the men who held it high was the Indian, Ira Hayes. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian, nor the Marine that went to war. Ira Hayes returned a hero, celebrated through the land. He was wined and speeched and honored. Everybody shook his hand. But he was just a Pima Indian. No water, no home, no chance. At home, nobody cared what Ira'd done. And when did the Indians dance? Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. Then Ira started drinking hard. Jail was often his home. They let him raise a flag and lower it like you'd throw a dog a bone. He died drunk early one morning, alone in the land he fought to save. 2 inches of water in a lonely ditch was a grave for Ira Hayes. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. Yeah, call him drunken Ira Hayes, but his land is just as dry, and his ghost is lying thirsty in the ditch where Ira died.
In a South Texas border town sat a boy and his guitar, and the people came from all around, and all the girls from there to Austin were slipping away from home and putting jewelry in pocket to take the trip to go and listen to the little dark-haired boy that played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play. Well, he couldn't ride or wrangle, and he never cared to make a dime, but give him his guitar, and he'd be happy all the time. And all the girls from 9 to 90 were snapping fingers, tapping toes, and begging him don't stop, and hypnotized and fascinated by the little dark-haired boy that played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play. Then one day he was gone, and no one ever saw him round. He vanished like the breeze, and they forgot him in the little town. But all the girls still dreamed about him, and hung around the cabaret until the doors were locked. And then one day, on the hit parade, was a little dark-haired boy that played a Tennessee flat-top box, and he would play. I found him by the railroad track this morning. I could see that he was nearly dead. I knelt down beside him and I listened just to hear the words the dying fella said. He said they let me out of prison out in Frisco. For 10 long years I paid for what I'd done. I was trying to get back to Louisiana to see my Rose and get to know my son. Give my love to Rose, please won't you, mister? Take her all my money, tell her buy some pretty clothes. Tell my boy that daddy's so proud of him. And don't forget to give my love to Rose. Won't you tell him I said thanks for waiting for me? Tell my boy to help his mom at home. Tell my Rose to try to find another. 'Cause it ain't right that she should live alone. Mister, here's the bag with all my money. It won't last them long the way it goes. God.
God bless you for finding me this morning. Now don't forget to give my love to Rose. Give my love to Rose, please won't you, mister. Take her all my money, tell her buy some pretty clothes. Tell my boy that daddy's so proud of him. And don't forget to give my love to
shirt. And then I washed my face and combed my hair, stumbled down the stairs to meet the day. I smoked my mind the night before with cigarettes and songs I'd been picking. Then I lit my first and watched the small boy cussing at a can that he was kicking. Across the empty street and caught the Sunday smell of someone frying chicken. And it took me back to something that I lost somewhere, somehow along the way. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. There's something in a Sunday that makes the body feel alone. And there ain't nothing short of dying, oh, half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk and Sunday morning coming down. In the park I saw a daddy with a laughing little girl that he was swinging. And then I stop beside a Sunday school and listen to the songs that they were singing. Then I went on down the road, and somewhere far away a lonely bell was ringing. And it echoed through the canyon like a disappearing dream of yesterday. On a Sunday morning sidewalk, I'm wishing, Lord, that I was stoned. 'Cause there's something in a Sunday that makes a body feel alone. There ain't nothing short of dying half as lonesome as the sound of a sleeping city sidewalk and Sunday morning coming down.
One dark and windy day, up on a ridge he rested as he went along his way, when all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged sky and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. The horns were black and shiny, and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the skies. Saw the riders coming far, and they heard their mournful cry. Yippee-yi, oh yippee-yi.
That Mason-Dixon line at daylight, would you tell that engineer to slow it down, or better still, just stop the train, 'cause I want to look around. Hey porter, hey porter, what time did you say? How much longer will it be till I can see the light of day? When we hit Dixie, will you tell that engineer to ring his bell and ask everybody that ain't asleep to stand right up and yell. Hey, porter, it's getting light outside. This old train is puffing smoke and I have to strain my eyes. But ask that engineer if he will blow his whistle, please. 'Cause I smell frost on cotton leaves and I feel that southern breeze. Hey porter, please get my bags for me. I need nobody to tell me now that we're in Tennessee. Go tell that engineer to make that lonesome whistle scream. We're not so far from home, so take it easy on the steam. Hey porter, please open up the door. When they stop this train, I'm gonna get off first, 'cause I can't wait no more. Tell an engineer, I said thanks a lot, and I didn't mind the fare. I'm gonna set my feet on southern soil and breathe that southern air.
Here's a Bob Dylan song. June and I recorded.
Long time ago.
Go away from my window. Leave at your own chosen speed. I'm not the one you want, babe. I'm not the one you need. You say you're looking for someone who's never weak, but always strong. Protect you and defend you, whether you are right or wrong. Someone to open each and every door. From the ledge, babe, go lightly on the ground. I'm not the one you want, babe. I'll only let you down. You say you're looking for someone to pick you up each time you fall. Together, flowers constantly, and to come each time you call. And we'll love you for your life and nothing more. But it ain't me, babe. No, 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 it ain't me, babe. It ain't me you're looking for, babe. You say you're looking for someone who promised never to part.
Yeah.
Someone to close his eyes for you. Someone
to
close
the
his
words.
Heart. And we'll love you for your life and nothing more. But it ain't me, babe. No, 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 it ain't me, babe. It ain't me you're looking for.
Give my love to Rose, please won't you, mister? proud of him. And don't forget to give my love to Rose. Won't you tell him I said thanks for waiting for me? Tell my boy to help his mom at home. Tell my Rose to try to find another. It ain't right that she should live alone. Mister, here's the bag with all my money. It won't last them long, though it goes. God bless you for finding me this morning. Now don't forget to give my love to Rose. Give my love to Rose, please won't you, mister? Take her all my money, tell her to buy some pretty clothes. Tell my boy that daddy's so proud of him. And don't forget to give my love to
Well, I left Kentucky back in 49 and went to Detroit working on assembly line. The first year they had me putting wheels on Cadillacs. Every day I'd watch them beauties roll by, and sometimes I'd hang my head and cry, 'cause I always wanted me one that was long and black. One day I devised myself a plan that should be the envy of most any man. I'd sneak it out of there in the lunchbox in my hand. Now getting caught meant getting fired, but I figured I'd have it all by the time I retired. I'd have me a car worth at least $100,000. I'd get it one piece at a time, and it wouldn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, 'cause I'll have the only one there is around. Well, the very next day when I checked in with my big lunchbox and with some help of my friends, I left that day with a lunchbox full of gear. Well, I never considered myself a thief, but GM wouldn't miss just one little piece, especially if I strung it out over several years. The first day I got me a fuel pump, the next day I got me an engine and a trunk, then I got me a transmission and all the chrome. The little things I could get in my big lunchbox, like nuts and bolts and all four shocks, the big stuff I snuck out in my buddy's mobile home. Well, up to now my plan went all right, till we tried to put it all together one night. That's when I discovered that something was definitely wrong. The transmission was a 53 and the motor turned out to be a 73, and when we tried to put in the bolts, all the holes were gone. So we drilled it out so that it would fit, and with a little bit of help from an adapter kit, had that engine running just like a song. The headlights, it was another sight. We had two on the left and one on the right, but when we turned out the switch, all three of them come on. Well, the back end looked kind of funny too, but we put it together, and when we got through, that's when we noticed that we only had one tail fin. About that time my wife walked out, and I could see in her eyes that she had her doubts, but she opened the door and said, "Honey, take me for a spin." So we went uptown just to get the tags, and I headed to ride on down Main Drag. You could hear everybody laughing for blocks around. But up there at the courthouse, they didn't laugh, 'cause to type it up, it took the whole staff. And when they got through, the title weighed 60 pounds. I got it one piece at a time, and it didn't cost me a dime. You'll know it's me when I come through your town. I'm gonna ride around in style, I'm gonna drive everybody wild, 'cause I'll have the only one there is around. Yeah, Red Rider, this is the Cottonmouth and the Psycho Billy Cadillac. Come on, on. Negatory on the cost of this machine there, Red Rider. You might say that I just went up to the factory there and picked it up. It's cheaper that way. What model is it? Well, it's a 49, 50, 51, 52, 53, 54, 55, 56, 57, 58, 59 automobile.
you ask me if I'll forget my baby. I guess I will someday. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way. You ask me if I'll get along. I guess I will some way. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way. God gave me that girl to lean on, then he put me on my own. Heaven help me be a man and have the strength to stand alone. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way. Well, you ask me if I'll miss her kisses. I guess I will every day. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way. You ask me if I'll find another. I don't know, I can't say. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way. God gave me that girl to lean on, then he put me on my own. Heaven help me be a man and have the strength to stand alone. I don't like it, but I guess things happen that way.
An old cowboy went riding out one dark and windy day. Up on a ridge he rested as he went along his way. When all at once a mighty herd of red-eyed cows he saw plowing through the ragged skies, and up a cloudy draw. Their brands were still on fire and their hooves were made of steel. Their horns were black and shiny and their hot breath he could feel. A bolt of fear went through him as they thundered through the sky. For he saw the riders coming hard, and he heard their mournful cry. Yippee-i-oh! Faces gaunt, their eyes were blurred, their shirts all soaked with sweat. He's riding hard to catch that herd, but he ain't caught them yet. Cause they've got to ride forever on that range up in the sky. All the horses snorting fire as they ride on, hear their cry. Riders floated on by him, he heard one call his name. If you want to save your soul from hell riding on our range, then cowboy, change your ways. They are with us, you will ride, trying to catch the devil's herd across these endless skies. Yippee-i-oh!
Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle. Audio Jungle.
Tonight we have a special show featuring comedy and country music. Country people not only have their own kind of music, they also have their own kind of humor, and good humor it is. So sit back and enjoy a laugh country style. Well, there was country musical troupe, a kicking, singing folk group. They sang the mountain ballads and the folk songs of our land. They were long on musical ability. Folks thought they would go far, but political incompatibility led to their downfall. Well, the one on the right was on the left, and the one in the middle was on the right, and the guy on the left was in the middle, and the guy in the rear was a Methodist. Hey, Gene C3 and Carly. Well, the curtain had ascended, a hush fell on the crowd, as thousands there were gathered to hear the folk songs of our land. But they took their politics seriously that night at the concert hall, as the audience watched deliriously, they had a free-for-all. Well, the one on the left was on the bottom, and the guy in the middle was on the top, and the guy on the left got a broken arm, and the guy on his rear said, "Oh dear." Hey, well, this should be a lesson. If you plan to start a folk group, that don't go mixing politics with the folk songs of our land. Just work on harmony and diction, and play your banjo well. And if you have political convictions, keep them to yourself. Well, the one on the right works in a bank, and the guy in the middle drives a truck. The guy on the left's an all-night DJ, and the one in the rear got drafted. Call him drunk and Ira Hayes.
He won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war.
Gather round me, people. There's a story I would tell about a brave young Indian that we should remember well. From the tribe of the Pima Indians, a proud and peaceful band, who farmed the Phoenix Valley in Arizona land. Down their ditches for 1,000 years, the waters grew Ira's people's crops, till the white man stole the water rights and the sparkling water stopped. Now Ira's folks were hungry, and their land grew crops of weeds. But when war came, Ira volunteered and forgot the white man's greed. Call him drunken Ira Hayes. He won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey-drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. There they battled up Iwo Jima's hill, 250 men, but only 27 lived to fight back down again. And when that fight was over, and when Old Glory raised, among the men to hold it high was the Indian Ira Hayes. call him drunken Ira Hayes. He won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey drinking Indian, nor the Marine that went to war. Ira Hayes returned a hero, celebrated through the land. He was wined and speeched and honored. Everybody shook his head. But he was just a Pima Indian. No water, no crops, no chance. At home, nobody cared what Ira had done. And when did the Indians dance? Then Ira started drinking hard. Jail was often his home. There they'd let him raise a flag and lower it like you'd throw a dog a bone. Well, he died drunk early one morning, alone in the land that he fought to save. 2 inches of water in a lonely ditch was the grave for Ira Hayes. Call him drunken Ira Hayes, he won't answer anymore. Not the whiskey drinking Indian nor the Marine that went to war. Yeah, call him drunken Ira Hayes, but his land is just as dry, and his ghost is lying thirsty in the ditch where Ira died. Ira Hayes. If I were a carpenter and you were a lady, would you marry me anyway? Would you have my baby?
If you were a carpenter and I were a lady, I'd marry you anyway. I'd have your baby.
Save your love through loneliness, save your love through sorrow. Gave you my onlyness, give me your tomorrow. If I were a miller and a mill wheel grind, would you miss your colored dress and your soft shoes shining?
If you were a miller and a mill wheel grinding, I'd miss my colored dress or my soft shoes shining.
Save your love through loneliness, save your love through sorrow. Gave you my onlyness, give me your tomorrow. If a tinker was my trade, would I still find you?
I'd be carrying the pots you made, hollowing behind you.
If I worked my hand in wood, would you still love me?
I'd answer you, yes I would.
Would you not be above me? Save your love through loneliness, save your love through sorrow. Gave you my onlyness, give me your tomorrow.
Coming down that railroad track. Hey, look yonder coming down that railroad track. It's the Orange Blossom Special, bringing my baby back. Ooh. Florida, and get some sand in my shoe. Or maybe California and get some sand in my shoes. I'll ride that orange blossom special and lose these New York blues. Whoa, whoa.
Say, man, when are you going back to Florida?
When am I going back to Florida? I don't know. Don't reckon I ever will.
Ain't you worried about getting your nourishment in New York?
Oh, I don't care if I do die, do die, do die, do die, do die.
Hey, talk about her rambling. She's the fastest train on the line. Talk about her traveling. She's the fastest train on the line. It's that orange blossom special rolling down the seaboard line.
Texas border town sat a boy and his guitar, and the people came for miles around, and all the girls from there to Austin were slipping away from home and putting jewelry in hot to take the trip to go and listen to the little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat top box, and he would play. Cared to make a dime, but give him his guitar and he'd be happy all the time, and all the girls from 9 to 90 were snapping fingers, tapping toes and begging him don't stop, and hypnotized and fascinated by the little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat-top box, and he was late. Like the breeze, and they forgot him in the little town, but all the girls still dreamed about him and hung around the cabaret until the doors were locked. And then one day on the hit parade was a little dark-haired boy who played the Tennessee flat-top box, and